Buenos dias, Elevate Church family. Can you believe it? We are launching the new year with 21 days of a time of prayer and fasting. Not just fasting, but prayer and fasting. And you know what? When you think about just fasting in general, just for your personal health, fasting has some great benefits like regulating your sugar level, regulating your blood pressure. It helps you think a lot clearer. If you've had some toxicity in your body, I'm telling you, fasting begins to break down those toxins that have been making you sluggish. It helps you think a lot more clear. It gives you a boost of energy. So just imagine, that's the physical aspect of fasting. Now just think about what it does in the spirit. Come on, when you fast and when you pray in the spirit, what happens is you draw closer to God. You can think more clear. You can feel the presence of God. In an instant, you pray. And it takes a moment, right, as you start taking a few days of fasting and praying. But there's something about a corporate fast when all of us together in this church, when we come together and we fast and we pray, something begins to break in the spirit. And there's this boost of joy and excitement and passion. And that's what we're praying for. In addition, for the next 21 days, you'll be having a vlog every single day for 21 days. And at 10 a.m. every day for 21 days, we're going to have a time of just worship online on Instagram, Facebook, YouTube. And we just want to make sure that you're being saturated with the presence of God, the peace of God, and the revelation of God. So be watching. Today, I have the honor of teaching the first devotion, which I'm going to call this. I'm going to call it Rebuild. And you know, we all entered a brand new year. And there are some things that we have to come to realization that 2020 caught us by surprise. I really believe that 2020 is something that was a great lesson, but now it's not just learning your lesson of maybe some things that you saw in yourself, in your family, in your lifestyle that was revealed, but now it's the year to apply in 2021. Let's apply what we learned. Let's start making the shift and the change. But here's the truth. You have to understand that God wants us to rebuild in 2021. Rebuild, that's what fasting does. You're basically rebuilding the spiritual health of your life. And I encourage you as you do this, that you listen to this vlog. For example, today I want to talk about Nehemiah. Nehemiah is the perfect example of rebuilding. He sees the walls of Jerusalem. They were all broken and burnt down. And here's the truth. I want you to write this truth down. It won't get fixed unless you know it's broken. It won't get fixed unless you know it's broken. This is the perfect time for you to acknowledge something in your life. There's at least one thing in your life that you know needs to change. And once you acknowledge it, then you can come to a place of healing and restoration. Look at what Nehemiah chapter 2 verse 18 says in the New King James Version. It says, "Let us rise and build." Then they all set their hands to this good work. Let us rise and let us build. And they all, notice it says they all, we're all fasting here corporately. I'm encouraging you to get on this and rise and know that it's time to put your hands to work. And I really believe that when we think about rebuilding, we have to think about this. I think there are some of you that are watching today that may feel like, hey, I feel like I've lost some things. Or maybe I lost myself. Or maybe I lost everything. I don't know what you've lost, but in God, there's nothing that you lose in God. God is a God who restores. As a matter of fact, when you read the book of Nehemiah, Nehemiah is a book of redemption and a second chance. You heard me right. God wants to bring redemption and a second chance. God is all about resetting people, rebuilding people, restoring people, and that's what he's doing in these next 21 days. And so what's interesting is what the children of Israel tried to do in 70 years of trying to rebuild these walls in their own strength, in their own wisdom, in their own ways of doing life. Let me tell you something, 70 years, they couldn't do it. All of a sudden, a man by the name of Nehemiah, a man who feared God, loved God, had a conviction of God, the Spirit of God speaks to him. And Nehemiah hears God saying, I want you to rebuild me the walls of Jerusalem. And Nehemiah, what the children of Israel couldn't do in 70 years, Nehemiah did it in 52 days. Just imagine that. He rebuilt the walls of Jerusalem. Come on, the broken city, the broken doors in 52 days. But he didn't do it alone. He did it with a people. a people that were willing to sacrifice. And fasting is sacrifice. Fasting is you pushing away the delicacies, the things that love. Listen, people don't die because they're not eating. People die because they overeat, okay? Food is a major issue for us, right? Like, you know, for example, I'm sure right before the fast, like myself, I just wanted to start, I was thinking cheeseburgers, pizza, donuts. I mean, it's just like the flesh already knows why. Because I'm about to put this flesh under. I'm about to put this flesh to a place of complete yielding and submitting to God. But I also have to realize that it's time to rebuild some things in my personal life, just like you're going to rebuild some stuff. So when you put God in the picture as you fast and pray, what took Nehemiah 52 days to rebuild, I believe that God can do something in 21 days. In the next 21 days, as you fast and pray, I want you to remember this. Number one, that blessings are found in the breaking. It's in this breaking point of our life that we know that something needs to change, that the blessing comes. And it's like when you look at the story of Jesus feeding the 5,000, this crowd was broken, this crowd was hurting, this crowd was, you know, desperate. Even Jesus looked at them and he said, you know, I feel for them. I really care about them. And that's why he was able to feed the 5,000, and he broke the bread and he blessed them. He broke the bread and then he blessed the fish and he fed 5,000. So the blessing is in the breaking. The second point is this, is that he feeds the multitude with your broken pieces. And this is true because in Nehemiah chapter 4, verse 1 and 2, it says, now Sanballat heard that we were rebuilding the wall. So he became very angry and upset. Listen, when you are desiring to change, the attack immediately comes. And it says right here, and he made fun of the Jews. He spoke to his friends and the army of Samaria. He said, what are those Jews trying to do? Can they make their city wall like new again? Will they offer sacrifices? Can they finish everything in a single day? The stones from their city wall and buildings are piled up like trash, and everything has been badly burned. Can they use those stones to rebuild everything again? And yes, Jesus feeds the multitude with your broken pieces. So if God can use Nehemiah to use those old, broken, burned pieces of stones, just imagine what he can do with you and I. So for the next 21 days, be watching our vlog every single day, our worship at 10 a.m., and stay connected. And I want you to fast for a change. God bless you.